run it through to Bashiri down to Trade Fair. This is the takeoff point for this particular one. This is the takeoff point for this. We have 7 of such that we want to work on right away.
Can you please come with the news, sir?
I have all that here. I'll supply you with them. But the total number of right now, I guess the areas we are working on right now, I'm not very sure we have such cases there. There are still other 8 areas, channels that we will attack, but much later. You understand? But right away, I can tell you that the government will not compensate anybody having a fish pond around the areas we are dredging. So it's an advice right away. If you have your fish pond around, you can go and harvest it, because we must avert disaster this coming rainy season. We must avert any ecological disaster. And that is the essence of taking off on time to ensure that we have free flow of erosion. Last week, we'll touch some other points. So, but you can see the heavy equipment on duty. Also advice, like I said earlier, there could be people around this area having their fish ponds. The government will not be responsible for any compensation, because the general interest of the public is more important to us now. And don't forget, we have the
Urban
Renewal Agency that will take charge of that. Once it contravenes the normal rule, we know what will happen. You understand? The general interest of the public is more important to Mr. Governor, and that is why we have sounded that one.
Close
to the car wash. And this one is Adere. Ready to the water wash. So when we complete that place, the machine will cross over. You understand? And clear it and make it as clean as what you saw here. So this is Adere Omission Jano. Straight to water wash. massive. It's very massive. It's not what you were expect to rent so soon. You can always check them doing the job. They are working, and you can always go there to see the beautiful job they are doing, the magnitude of job being done. You can answer that yourself with what you have seen this morning.
For me, for the public.
Yeah, you help us tell the public that you have seen. So whoever is alleging government of not doing any job is on his own. It's just mere unnecessary propaganda, you know. It's uncalled for, and we are not bothered about that. What is important to us is to get the job done, and the people will feel it. When we started this job last week, Saturday, you can see the residents trooping out to hail Oshoko, Oshoko, Oshoko. You understand? So, we are more interested in doing the job for public to see. You will feel it yourself. It's not a matter of what we say on the camera. You understand? So, you can form your opinion. You press men. You have seen it yourself. We have visited about 4 places this morning, and you have seen the magnitude of job being done. And they are still moving to other places in Ado-Ekiti.
Yeah. And probably to places where...
Like I told you, we have 2 contractors handling the job. And they have been given specification. They are to work on specific areas. So wherever your question comes in, the contractor will take care of that. Like this culvert you are standing on. If they dredge, the dredging you see coming up there, there is no how we will not break this cover and open it up to link up to the other end. So that will definitely take care of some of the problems. By the time we have free flow of this, then there won't be flooding and there won't be disaster. And you were asking me about people having their houses very close to the canal. The rule is there, 30 meters from it. If you contravene, you are on your own. You understand? You should not build your house. I mean, you should leave a gap of 30 meters to the canal. So if you decide to violate, then whatever happens to you is your problem. You understand? So that's the situation. Like I intimated you earlier, the state government has embarked on massive dredging of stream channels in Ado-Ekiti in order to avert this perennial disaster that they used to experience here. So I'm happy you have gone around with me. You have visited the locations yourself. You see the contractors on site working. Like I told you earlier, we have Mega Aggregates and Sam Chase handling the contract. We are channelizing about 7 areas in Ado-Ekiti. And you have seen the locations yourself. And apart from the 7 major channels, we have about 8 tributaries that will be connected, that will be channelized towards the major ones. So, by the grace of God, the government of Dr. Peter Oyedele Fayose is doing everything possible to avert unnecessary disaster coming up in form of ecological problem this year. So, the contract is going to take about 3 months, but you can see they have started very well. You have visited the back of Christ Gates there, where they have never done any channelization in Ado-Ekiti. And we are embarking on it. That's a virgin site. And you have seen the job being done. I hope you will tell the Thomas Didymus, all the pessimists, that the job is on. You have been paid. They've been peddling a lot of rumor that so amount has gone to Ekiti State. Nothing is being done. You have seen it yourself. Please tell our people in Ekiti, in Nigeria, that Governor Oyedele Fayose is working. Thank you very much. There is this fund meant for this purpose, and it's being spent on the purpose for which is given for. So the idea of Ekiti not having money remains a fact up to now. We don't have money. But you see, the federal government will not just open, will not allow ecological problem to erode the whole nation. You understand? So there are specific areas. Our governor cried out to them, and they are attending to us, and is attending to the problem accordingly. So it's ongoing. as the moment we started the job, we started observing some other problems too. So it's an ongoing thing, and it's going to spread beyond Ado Ekiti. It's a project that will go beyond Ado, go to Efon, go to Ifaki, go to other areas that are disaster prone. Like I've told you, what is important to us in Ekiti is to spend the money for the purpose that it's been designed for. And that is what Mr. Governor is doing. Those who has been given the job, and accordingly they will explain that to you. Contractor and Ariwola, that's why I said the contractor will avail you with the actual something. But if I may answer your question, money given to the state government for ecological problem, you understand? And what you have seen yourself is ecological, isn't it? So it's not being spent on housing. It's not being spent on road mending or whatever. It's not being spent as a welfare thing for old women, the project of the former, you understand? So it's being spent for the purpose for which it has been given for.
So how much is that money?
People having fish ponds in this area. And again, we have been facing this major challenge in areas where the government has never channelized before. Like behind the Christ School, Ado Ekiti there, Christ Girls School, is a virgin place that is just being newly channelized. So those are the few challenges we are having, but we are on top of the situation. We are surmounting the situation by the grace of God. It's a continuous exercise. But this particular one, we have encouraged them to do the embankment very well. I specifically instructed them to make it like angle 45, to bevel, such that even if it's going to wash back, it's going to take some time, you understand? But meanwhile, it's a continuous project, it's a continuous exercise. And also, that takes us back to this issue of waste management and the attitude of our people to waste disposal in Ekiti. You see, we have been encouraging our people to dispose their waste where they are supposed to dump them. We have the waste bins all over Ado Ekiti, but you still see people throwing things into the canal. It's not in the best interest of the residents of Ado Ekiti. When we encounter flooding, we keep shouting, government, government. It's not all about government. It's not Governor Adeleye Fawoshe that drinks a sachet of pure water and drops it inside the gutter. It's not me that draws the bottle of empty bottle of water inside the canal. So our people should learn to pack their waste properly and dump where they are supposed to dump it. So it's a two-way thing. The government is doing its own side. We encourage our people to discharge their duty accordingly. That is obeying the rules. You have the waste bins, you still find people dumping just by the waste bin. It takes them, it's very difficult for them to put the waste inside the thing. So it's, the whole thing is related. The waste management and the dredging we are doing, they are interrelated. If you keep dumping your refuse there, you are not helping the government, and neither are you even helping yourself. Because when your area gets flooded, you will shout, you will come and meet Mr. Governor, please help us. So who caused it? We are all responsible for it. But the contractors will know how many they want to engage. But if they can manage, we have time frame for the contract. Even if they are using one and they can finish within 3 months, it's okay by us. But they have 3 on ground now. As long as they comply with the specifications, as long as they finish within the specific time, we don't have problem with the number of equipment they have on ground.
Obviously, the state government is desirous of channelization of the streams in Ado Ekiti here. And it's also about dredging the streams so that we have free flow of water, or rain water, during this forthcoming rainy season. We've got 3 equipments, which they're called Swan Boogies. You can see, they're called Swan because they're massive. And they will definitely be working for the next 1 or 2 months, clearing all streams, all channels, making sure they're wide enough for the rain waters to be able to pass freely. And that's exactly what we're doing. Like you heard earlier on, the first one is working around NTA. We're here at Christ Girls area, and of course the people here are very, very happy that we're here to do it because they experience flooding every year. You know, it's a very difficult one. But by the very special grace of God, we should be able to clear the streams in the next 1 or 2 months before the rains, and I'm sure we'll have a flood-free year. Thank you. His Excellency has just called us, Governor Fayose, to monitor things himself. So everybody, all hands are on deck to make sure that flooding is a thing of the past in this state.
It's one of the policy of the state government to see to the yearning and aspiration of the people. And one of the area of concern of the people is this issue of flooding that we always have on a yearly basis. So the government has said, okay, we want to do the flooding of all the channels in Abeokuta. And we have about 7 stream channels that we want to enlarge to be able to accommodate all the runoff that might arise during rainfall. That's the reason why we are carrying out all this.
We are very excited in the sense that here is a proactive government that responds to the needs of the people. So, and to resolve all the challenges that rainwater and stormwater brings to this area is a very exciting thing. More so that we are expecting the rains anytime from now. So we are very happy. As a resident, we are happy. And for having been in this area, when the whole of this area was bush, I think it's a great relief.
Fe mo fe ba wa se adugbo yi. Emi go fi oladugbo yi gan toro. Pe ayipada rere to de ba adugbo.
Asipo
ko lo je ko de ba emi kan. Tori pe o ti pa ti mo tin gbe bi bayi lati bi 10 years ago. Ko si nkan kan ta le adugbo yi o. But awa dupe lowo Fayose bayi. Oga wa Osoko.
Osoko mala, olori oko ba pa.